Welcome back to my channel. My name is Sarah and I create videos on pretty much home management and home organization. And one of the big parts of that is managing our personal finances. So in today's video, I'm going to take a look at my own sinking funds. A sinking fund is like multiple little saving pots that you can put money away each month and that adds up over time. You can do sinking funds for things like Christmas or gifts, or for myself, I've got spending money pot and even a baby pot. So at the beginning of the month when I get paid and all of my bills go out, I like to send the majority of my money over to my sinking funds and then give that money a purpose. So the way I manage this, I use a Google Sheets spreadsheet and it gives me like a snapshot of the entire year on how my sinking funds are doing, how much money I put in and how much money I've taken out. So I'm going to show you how to do that today and I'm going to set it up for the whole of January. So I've got two different savings accounts with Starling Bank. One is my own personal and the other one is the joint one for the family. So I'm going to look at my own personal first. These are the different goals that I've set myself. I've got a car tax, which I like to pay in full. Car insurance, I like to pay in full, and car M&T, that I like to pay for and have the money set aside for before it comes down to actually having the M&T or the insurance being paid and the tax being paid. So I've got my dog walking business insurance, my new car fund, Christmas gifts, baby, Jonathan, which is my brother, my sister Amy, my sister Kathleen, a hen I'm going to be going on, my hair and beauty, and spending money. So these are the little counts that I like to actually designate money to each month. If you think about, for example, spending money or say hair and beauty, I could now say I want to get my nails done, my eyebrows done, my hair done, and just go because I feel like it. Or I can say, I really want to get my hair, nails and eyebrows done, let's have a look how much money I've got. And I set only a small amount aside every month, so that means that I don't overspend in this category, because I need to say, for example, if I'm putting £10 in a month and I need £60 to get all of that work done, I'll then have to wait those 6 months in order to be able to afford it, if that makes sense. So you're not overspending and doing it willy-nilly and when you want to. It's actually governed by how much money you've actually got in that pot. Here I've got the goal, so what is the quantity I want in that at the end goal? What is the end date that I want that by? So Christmas will be December, so I'll put December in there. How many months to get there? I'm only going to have 11 paychecks, or is it 10 paychecks? Yeah, I'm going to have 11 paychecks to reach before I reach Christmas, so I need to make sure that that's 11 months. This is going to kind of be looked at by dividing how much you want, the goal, with the actual how many months you've got to spend, and that's pretty much how much ideally I'd like to put in a month. This goal per month doesn't mean I'm going to hit this amount a month, because it depends how much money I've got to put in my account overall. And then I'm going to put January, so the start of January, how much I've got at the start of January, how much I've added in throughout January, so I'll do this at the end, how much I've withdrawn from the account that month, and then the start of Feb, so what's left over in that account. And then I'm just going to continue that until the end of the year. So I've only done until June. So I'm going to continue that until the end of the year. And then hopefully by the end of this, I'll have a much larger pot, because it's actually visual and it's less likely I'm going to spend the money because it's got its own purpose. Okay, so let's have a look at what I've done with my sinking funds. Okay, so if we go through them one by one, so these are the goals that I've set myself. So my car tax costs £155, so I want to make sure I've got that in there. Car insurance is roughly about £250. I think last year it was about £235, so I put it up to £250 just for a bit of a buffer. MOT up at £70, I know it's more around £55, so that again gives me a little bit of a buffer in case. And my dog walking insurance is £147, so I put £150 in that pot. Car, I need £2,400 is what I'm planning on paying off this year. So it will take me a few years to pay it off, but this year is what I'm planning on spending, and yeah, so that's how much I want in that pot. Christmas, I've got £300, gifts, £300, baby, I've put £450 because I've got the £650 already. So my overall goal is £1,000, but how much I'm planning on saving this year is only the £450 to try and get that buffer up until I hit my goal. Jonathan, I want £500 in, Amy, £500 in, Kathy. Now, this is a bit weird that I'm setting money aside for my siblings, but I'm the oldest of my sisters, and my brother lives abroad. And if ever they ever come into trouble, know that I've got a bit of money aside to be able to help. Or if, for example, they've got a big birthday party that I'm almost always responsible for planning, then that gives me that little bit of buffer. My brother's last year was going through a bit of a terrible time, and I was grateful that I had a bit of money set aside in order to be able to help him get through that. And he's found his feet now, he's doing amazing, I'm so proud of him. But sometimes we just need a little bit of help and we don't have the parents to be able to help us. So although they're all financially stable, they've all got really good jobs, and it's not a huge concern, and I'm not just giving them money, it's just that little bit of buffer in case there is desperate need and I'm able to help. So Mena's hen, I've got one hen planned for 2023, so I'm going to start saving up for that. I've already got £100, so I need to start. The goal for this is £400. My hair and beauty, again, this is, I don't get my hair done very often. I'd say probably 5 or 6 months until I get my hair, and I like to let it grow as long as possible. And my eyebrows are again very infrequently. I tend to pluck them, but then when it comes time to re-sculpt my eyebrows because I need them doing, then I'll spend the money and get like HD brows done, and then maintain that through plucking and dyeing myself. And spending money at 180, I don't know why I've said that much. That's quite a lot. I'm going to take that down a bit. I'm going to take it down to £100. So this is like an overall goal, it's not a monthly goal. This is kind of what I'd like to see in my account like at the end of the year, if I'm able to keep those savings going. Then end date, let's have a look at when I've set these end dates. Okay, so for my car tax, I'd like it to be done in July. Car insurance, July, MOT, July, because I know I pay all these in August. Dog walking business is August. New car is December. Christmas, December, and gifts. I just want to have a good little pop going. Baby is September, hopefully, fingers crossed, because that is 9 months from now, so here's hoping. Jonathan, I've got December, Amy, December, and Catherine, December. Again, these dates are kind of like just a set goal, just to give myself some sort of end mark. Mena's hen is February 2023. Hair and beauty is June. I've just, again, set 6 months away and spending money June. So obviously, my spending money, I'll be putting in, taking out, but I'd like to have a little bit of a buffer there, and I set that as £100 to have that in my account pretty much at all times. So months, I've just put in how many months away July is, how many months away August is, how many months away December is, etc. I've then taken the goal amount divided by the amount of months it takes to get there. I've rounded up a lot of the time, so it's not exactly, it is rounded up slightly just because I like to put a set amount into the account. If I'm transferring £500 from my Access account, it's better to have like whole numbers rather than the odd pennies here and there. My car tax, I'd like to put £20 in a month, £35 in for my car insurance, £10 in for my MOT, £20 for my dog walking business. New car, I am putting aside £200 a month for my new car. When I hit £1,000, I send that money to my parents-in-law. It's a slow way for me to pay this off, but it's a safe way because there's no extra interest. Christmas, I do £30 a month because that will then give me the £300 by the end of the year. £30 for gifts as well. This is just a guest figure. £50 for a baby, that's my own baby. Hopefully we have one in the future, and I like to have a nice little account so that when I'm on maternity leave, I've got a bit of money to go coffee shopping. Obviously my salary's not going to be full, so that just gives me that little bit of money to kind of play with and enjoy the time. Also things like maternity clothes and the odd bits or the indulgence expenses I want to make for the baby. £10 for Jonathan, £20 for Amy, and £20 for Caffeine. The reason the girls are more than Jonathan is because at the moment I think I've got £300 in Jonathan's account, and these girls are empty, so I want to try and build them up. Mena's hen is £30 a month, again divided by the 13, that gives me like a nice number to send over and not like a huge amount at one time or too little. So too little is dangerous because when it comes down to the hen, I want to have the money there, I don't want to have to scrounge around everywhere else for it. Hair and beauty and then is 20, and then spending money is £30 a month, and more than likely I'm going to spend that £30 a month. It's unlikely that I'm going to be able to build that. The ideal thing about this is that you're giving yourself money, and that money has that purpose. And for example, spending money, that is money I can spend. That guilt-free money. I can use that money to do whatever I want with, whether it is going for coffee, or buy myself a new memory card or whatever. So for example, if I need something that's say £60 and I've only got the £30 in that spending account, then I'm going to hold off on buying that until next month, because I'll then add I won't spend any money in that account, and then by next month I'll have £60. So that's how you pay it, rather than overspending on something and then regretting it later. So the total of this is reflected here, so that's £525. This all depends on how much money I've got to send over into my savings. Okay, so this varies every month because I get paid differently every month. So how kind of my extra spare money is what goes into here, and that's what the total is. So if I've got £525 after all of my bills have gone out, after I've saved in my actual savings account and I've saved for the house, this money is kind of to play with. So if I've got £525, that is ideally how much I'd like to put in each pot. Okay, so I've put in my January sinking funds, how much I have sent over. So these are the goals of what I'd like in them, and this is what I've got in them currently. So I've currently only got £835 in my Starlings personal Starlings account, and this is what I got. I've got my full amount for my car tax. I've got no money for my car insurance or my MOT. £50 in for my dog walking business, so that's starting to build up nicely. I've got £200 in car. Christmas, I've got no money in because obviously it is January today. Gifts, I've got £61. Baby, nothing. Jonathan, £300. Amy's, £59. Kathleen's, none. Kathleen's got none, so I need to start building that. Kathleen's is probably going to be spent on a hen when I get that to £500, because she is engaged and she's due to get married possibly 2023 or 2020, so that gives me a bit of time to build that. Bella's pen is the set date, and I've only got £10 in there at the moment, so I'm going to start building hair and beauty. I've got nothing in, and spending money, I've got nothing in. So my sinking funds have had a real hit last year because I paid for my teeth, which I managed to pay in full. I paid for my car, so the deposit on my car, and any extra money I kind of threw out of my car to try and get that down as much as I can. So this year is about building this back up again. Okay, so this is what we've added in this month. I haven't put any money into my car tax because I've got the full amount there. I have put £40 in there, which is a little bit more than the goal per month, but again, I'm thinking let's try and get this done quickly. Car MOT, I've put £10 in, £20 in my dog walking business, £200 for the car, £30 for Christmas, £30, £50 for baby, £10 for Jonathan, £20 for Amy, Kathleen, I put £20, Menace hen, £30, and hair and beauty, £10, and spending £30. So I've managed to take some money out of my goal for my hair and beauty and put it in towards my car insurance. I'm just thinking that that's more of a priority. I'm not really worried about getting my hair done. So I only had the £500 in order to put into this account, and that's how I've spent it. So at the end of the month, I'll have a look at what I've spent out of each account, and I'll stick that in there, and then we'll start nicely in February. So that is how I do my sinking funds every month. I will be doing a video so that you can see the progression over the year. I really hope you enjoyed this. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button. So remember, I do a lot of videos on anything to do with the home organization and home management. So personal finances does come into this, but obviously I do a lot of cleaning videos and meal prepping. If that is of interest to you, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so it will alert you when I have any further videos coming on. If you want to know a little bit more about how I budget my money, then click this video here, and I will see you in my next video.